Getting started with Qiskit. Qiskit is an open source framework developed by IBM for quantum computing. With it, you can create, simulate, and run quantum algorithms. More information about Qiskit can be found at Qiskit.org. Now we're going to walk through a little bit of a Qiskit demo. So first, we'll start in our Jupyter notebook by importing Qiskit. Next, we're going to create a circuit so that we can simulate. We'll start by creating a classical register and a quantum register, and then put those together to make a quantum circuit. We can draw the circuit. So far, there's nothing interesting there, but we'll add some gates soon. Now we're going to add an X gate, and we'll draw our new circuit. So here we've added an X gate to our top qubit, qubit zero. We'll add a little bit more to the circuit. So two H gates and a CNOT gate. We'll draw the circuit. As a note, there's many different gates that you can add to your circuit. As a note, you can, in Jupyter Notebook, press Shift and Tab to get more information about the object you're working with. So here we're working with a quantum circuit. And then you can click Tab to see what different options you have for that particular object. So we can see that we have our different gates. For example, here's our X gate, our Y gate, our Z gate. And then you can easily just add them onto your quantum circuit. So we'll put back the Hadamard gate. Now we're gonna add measurement operations. These measurement operations allow us to receive an output when we simulate and run on a real quantum machine. Here, as a note, I decided to use the MPL option to make a little bit of a prettier circuit diagram. Now we're gonna go ahead and create a simulator, and we'll execute our circuit on the simulator using 1024 shots. Once we've run our job, we can go ahead and plot our results. So here we can see that we have a 100% chance of being in state 1-1. With Qiskit, we can also do state vector analysis. So once again, we're gonna go ahead and create a circuit. This time we only have one qubit and one bit in those registers. We'll combine them to create a quantum circuit. After that, we'll add an X gate and draw. The state vector tool allows us to analyze the state of our quantum circuit. Since we have an X gate on our qubit, we would expect to be in the Ket 1 state. When we look at our state vector, that is the state that we are in. So we have a 0 for the Ket 0 basis and a 1 for the Ket 1 basis. So these would be our probability amplitudes that we would see in either our vector notation for our quantum state or our Brockett notation. Now let's do a little bit of a test where we look at the state vector for a multi-qubit system. So we're going to create a two-qubit system, and we're going to place an X gate on that qubit zero and draw. The state vector might look a little different than what we'd expect. We have a state 0100 rather than 0010. Why is this? Qiskit uses a different ordering for the qubits. Here, Qiskit uses top bottom from least significant to most significant qubit. That's different from in class where we used the notation of top down left right for top being the most significant qubit and bottom being the least significant qubit.